And welcome to the Sportscast, April 23rd, 2018, the NBA playoffs, second weekend of the first round. Things are kind of tidying up. One series is over. Some series are tied 2-2, and some series where teams are strengthening their positions. We got Jorge Montoya on the line. Hey, George, how are you?
I'll go, Santiago. Thanks for having me.
So, George, exciting series this past weekend. Let's start with the first one. The Bucks had tied the series against the Celtics by defeating them 104-102. How do you see this series? Do you think the Bucks have a chance?
You know, this is a series that, like, you know, so before it started, obviously we talked about it, you know, it was a toss-up. Like, we weren't really sure what to expect. In my mind, I always thought, you know, Boston's going to win. You know, I think I said it was the before two, I believe. But this has been a series where obviously home field advantage is like basically what's giving them each team the momentum, because the Bucks playing amazing at home, you know, and the crowd is into it. They've been close games, but you know, this is the one where I think if any team beats the other team at home, I think that's the team that have the edge. So right now it's tied, but if it goes the way it's going, you know, Celtics wins game seven. But if the Bucks could win one at Boston, I think they'll get the advantage, you know. So I think that's what's going to come down to.
Jason Tatum had 21 points. Al Horford had 13. Jaylen Brown had 13 points from the Boston Celtics. Milwaukee Bucks, Chris Middleton had 23. The Greek Freak had 27. Malcolm Brandon had 10. Jabari Parker had 16. You think the Greek Freak is really sprouting?
Yeah, man. You know what to expect from him in a given night. I mean, he's doing really, really good. Chris Middleton has actually stepped up huge. And actually, I think he made a mistake. Jaylen Brown didn't have 13. He had 34 points that game. So he's Jaylen Brown is really, like I said, him and Jaylen.
No, sorry, he had 34 points.
Yeah, Jaylen Brown is like their best player. You know, obviously when Harry Irving and Gordon is out, so Jaylen Brown really is the one that, you know, that he could. You know, he's a very solid player, very a lot of promise. I still think Boston has a better all around team, but Milwaukee, you know, with the Greek, you know, with Giannis, he's just, you know, like he's such a dominant player, and Jabari Parker's been coming off the bench strong too. So it's a close series. I still think Boston will pull it out, but you know, they can underestimate the Bucks. I mean, and you know, I think I still think Boston will make it out, but it's going to be a grueling series, Game 6, 7, most likely probably 7. You know,
I agree. I think it might come down to 7 games, unless Boston really acts up and maybe get it down to 6. But I think it's like you were saying, it's a home game type of series. You know, no one's winning away so far, so we'll see. We'll see what happens. The next series, which I thought would be a sweep. The Spurs hold off the Golden State Warriors 3-1, and the Spurs defeated the Golden State Warriors 103-90. Do you think the Warriors still has this series?
Of course. The Warriors are going to win it. I think Ginobili, you know, he came out of the bench in the fourth quarter and had like 10 points, and he, you know, he sparked them up, and they played for Pop. You know, his wife passed, and second game back to back, and I think, you know, so they came out, I think they gave the last thing they had left, and it was just enough. I think the Warriors struggled shooting, but that's it. I don't see the Warriors are gonna close it out at home, you know, and being done.
We have some breaking news.
Spurs actually went. Yeah,
breaking news. Spurs announced Ettore Messina will coach game 5 versus the Warriors.
Yeah, I mean, Pop is already, you know, he's, you know, I'm sure it's such a, you know, tough scenario. He and his family, or his wife passed, and that's more important than basketball. So, yeah, I don't see him coming back, you know, coach, you know, I mean, unless miraculously the Spurs, you know, come back and win the series, you know, which, I mean, it's like, I think that's the most unlikeliest team to come back down 3-1. I mean, the Spurs are just older, you know, they're missing, you know, their best player, and, you know, the Warriors, even, you know, they don't have that often, like, bad shooting nights like they did that one time, you know.
Ginobili had 16 points. Kyle Anderson had 10. DeJounte Murray had 12. LaMarcus Aldridge had 22. Rudy Gay had 14. For Golden State, Kevin Durant had 34 points. Klay Thompson, 12. And Sean Livingston, 10. It seems like Golden State didn't have much weapons. They just used those three main players, but San Antonio had more weapons that showed up.
Well, yeah, Klay Thompson, you know, went 4-for-16. You know, you don't ever see that happening. So he struggled. He was really Kevin Durant did what he had to do, even though he still, you know, he shot a lot of times. But Klay Thompson was the one that didn't necessarily do much that game. So without Curry there, Klay Thompson was the one that has to go off. But Klay Thompson, he's still a great player, and yeah, he's had an off night, and that was a difference maker. Last night.
The other game last night, which really surprised me, was the Wizards tying up the series against the Raptors, 106-98. I really thought that the Raptors would just close up the series or maybe be up 3-1. Do you think it's going to be a tight series?
Yeah, you know, that's interesting, too, because I thought the Wizards were done. I didn't think they had much, but it's kind of similar to the Boston and Milwaukee. You know, they got back home, they had life into them. You know, they were playing a lot better at home, and, Bradley Beal stepped up huge. Last game, he had 31 points, and, John Wall is the one who's consistently playing well, and so, yeah, Bradley Beal is the one that has to kind of, you know, keep up pace with Wall, and he's done a great job. Toronto is very, very tough to beat at home, and it comes down to that. I feel like the same thing with Milwaukee against Boston is they have to take one away from them away. So this is a huge series. I think this is like game five is really what I think will determine who wins both series. So if either Washington or Milwaukee win away game five, I think they're going to have the series. They're going to have the momentum going back home, you know, and so I think that's what they need to do. They need to win that fifth game coming up. But I still say Toronto is going to pull it off, you know.
I agree. I think like the other series of Milwaukee-Boston, there has to be a team that has to win away. It's tough, but in order to move forward in the playoffs or to win a championship, you got to win away. In Toronto, DeRozan had 35 points. Jonas Valanciunas had 11. Kyle Lowry had 19. Jakob Poeltl had 10. For the Wizards, Otto Porter Jr. had 12. Marcin Gortat had 12. John Wall had 27. Bradley Beal had 31.
Yeah, he played a great that game. Kind of like Klay Thompson. He's one of those guys who's a streaky shooter. He's on. Bradley Beal, you know, complemented well with John Wall. And then the rest of the guys, you know, the Morris, Gortat, and Porter, they play good defense. So, they're not there ready to score 20, 30 points a game. The offense goes through Wall and then Bradley on Beal. So, we'll see what happens. But I still take Toronto at home, you know.
Do you think Toronto will win in 7 or in 6?
I mean, like I said, it could very well go game 7. Washington's been playing great at home. And, you know, but Toronto's very hard to beat at home. And that's the thing. That's why I'm hoping that's important. It's like, you know what, at worst case scenario, you take care of your home court and you're going to win out anyway in game 7. So that's the thing. And I think Toronto, if I remember correctly, I'm thinking along with Houston were like the best home teams. I think Toronto had the best record at home. Let me look into that real quick. But I think Toronto at home, they were 34-7, man, the regular season. I mean, that was the best record, I think, of any team. Let me look.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, they were tied with Houston, 34-7. So Houston and even San Antonio was funny. San Antonio was 33-8 at home. But, yeah, they're the best home team. So Toronto was very hard to beat at home, you know.
The next match, Cleveland Cavaliers versus the Indiana Pacers. Interesting series. It's a test of the no Kyrie year. It seems like, you know, Cavaliers defeated the Pacers 104-100. Do you think the Cavs are holding on by a thread?
Yeah. Pacers have given them everything. I mean, they've given them just so much fit, so much struggles. I mean, LeBron had to do everything. I mean, absolutely everything. You know, and Kevin Love is just struggling. I don't know what's going on with him. He only had 5 points that game, 2-for-10. But LeBron James was doing basically, he almost had a triple double again. And, I mean, LeBron is playing lights out and they're barely winning. So I still say Cleveland will squeak by, but I think by the time they go to the second round, if it's Toronto or the Wizards, they're going to, I think they're done, man. I really don't see if it's Toronto. I don't even know if they have enough left Toronto, but also if Toronto goes to game seven, we're going to be beat down teams playing each other. But, I guess we'll talk more about who I think is going to come out of the East. But, yeah, Cleveland is just struggling. But, you know, they have LeBron James. As long as he continues to go off, you know, he has just enough to get through, you know.
That's Cleveland's secret weapon. J.R. Smith had 12 points. LeBron James had 32. Kyle Korver, 18. Jordan Clarkson had 12. And Kevin Love had 5. For Indiana, Bojan Bogdanovic had 10. Thaddeus Young, 12. Miles Turner, 17. Oladipo, 17. Collison, 12. Lance Stephenson, 11. And Sabonis, 19. Now, in my opinion, the most surprising team or the strongest team after the 76ers is Indiana. Does Indiana have enough to beat Cleveland?
I mean, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all seven players of the main rotations, they all have double-digit scoring. So they're a balanced team, and we saw what happened when Novicic, how you pronounce that, Bojan, yeah, he goes off, he's a great, shooter, and, Victor Oladipo and, Miles Turner, and those guys are all solid players. So can they be, I think at this point they've shown that they can compete at a high level. No one really gave them a chance, I think, going into the playoffs. But when you think about it, in the regular series, I think they won 3-1. You know, so they match well up against Cleveland. And I didn't think it would be – I mean, I thought Cleveland would win 4-2. But at this point, hey, man, you go to Game 7, who knows what could happen, you know. And didn't Indiana win at Cleveland already, right?
Yeah, they did in the first game, Game 1.
Exactly. So they're capable of winning at Cleveland. We know that. So who knows? They could pull an upset and win Game 7 for all we know. So that's the thing. You know, Kevin Love is really, the key for Cleveland. Kevin Love just plays, he hits his shots. You know, that's the X factor there. And he's been struggling lately, so LeBron's done a lot of work. But, Cleveland, I mean, Pacers could beat Cleveland. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if they do.
Yeah, I think it's going to come down to seven games as far as I can see. I mean, unless the Pacers really tip over and try to do it in six. But we'll see what happens. For predictions tonight, we got the Houston Rockets playing the Timberwolves. The Wolves won game 3. The series is at 2-1. Who do you think will win game 4 tonight?
Well, finally, the Minnesota won a game, which I'm not saying it's surprising, but Houston was beating them so dominantly in the first two games that I thought, you know what, this could be a 4-0, you know, kind of like the Blazers kind of, got beat up 4-0. I'm like, well, this could be a 1-2 now. But Ricky Rubio played great that game. He carried, and Butler and Towns are playing better. So, they're doing a good job. So I think, not Ricky Rubio, I don't want to say Rubio, we already played last year with them. I'm saying Butler and Towns doing well. And I always forget Rubio went to the Jazz, But but I mean, the Rockets are gonna win the series. I mean, they're still a way more dominant team, but I thought they were gonna win 4-2. I think the series, the Rockets. So Timberwolves might have another game. They might win here and then, or they're gonna lose 4-1. But yeah, Rockets are still too dominant.
There you go. George says Houston still has the edge over Minnesota. I thought this would be a sweep, but Minnesota has some good players. I think people are underestimating, Jimmy Butler, Towns, and Jeff Teague. But I think at the best they can do is, take Houston to 6 games. But if not, it might be 5. The next match, OKC versus the Jazz. This is the series that I thought beforehand will be a series. The Jazz took the series 2-1. Ricky Rubio is doing big things. Who do you think will win game 4?
That's the thing. Like, I mean, I thought OKC would win 4-2, even 4-1. But the Jazz is just, You know, like I said, that team is solid. And Rubio has been. I always liked Rubio. I always been a fan of him back when he was in the. I don't understand why they let him go. You know, when he was in the Timberwolves. But you know what? He's grown to as a player, and he's really good. So, I wouldn't be surprised Utah ends up winning. But you saw Westbrook. He's pretty heated up, and he said, you know, that he's going to shut down Rubio this game, and he won't have a triple double again. You know, so Westbrook is like putting up on himself to take him out the game this tonight. So, I think this game, like you said, is going to be very competitive in the series. So, you know, they are playing at home. So, I mean, if the Jazz go up 3-1. I mean, I think they'll have the series. I don't think Thunder has it to come back, win 3 in a row. So it's a must win for Oklahoma. But I think Westbrook's going to dominate. I don't see him. I see him tying up the series.
Yeah, I think the key of this team and the heart and soul is Russell Westbrook, and he has to show up. I mean, Paul George has some, you know, few amazing moments, but I think, you know, the shots or the winning shot has to be, you know, given to Russell Westbrook. So let's see what happens. And it is a must win. It is a must win for OKC, because being down 3-1, like, you know, you were saying, coming back from a 2-0 deficit is not easy.
Yeah, it's not.
Anyways, the 76ers and Heat, do you think the 76ers are pretty much the real deal? Like, are they going to win the series but then take over the East?
Man, I'm so agitated, man, I mean, I think it's the best series in all the playoffs. I mean, if you look at the games and watch all of them, man, they're going at it, man. The Heat are giving them everything they have. And that's the thing, man. Like, last game, you know, I'm a huge Heat fan, and I was really sure we were going to win. Because we're basically, halfway through the third quarter, we were like, looked like we were going to get it, you know, that type of series. And, you know, and man, like, what's his name? The 76ers were a lot of turnovers. They were just turning the ball over, but they were still within less than 8 points. I'm like, how are they still in it when they're not even playing that well? They're not shooting out well the threes. Yeah, they're right there. They were in the Heat were missing all their free throws. So I'm thinking they got closer and closer, and then they went on a run, and then the fourth quarter comes, and now we came and shoot a basket. Now Wade's the only one doing anything. No one can make a basket, and at this point, man, Simmons and that Joel Embiid, man, he was really the key. You know, I gave the series to the Heat before Embiid came back. I thought he would miss maybe a couple more games, and he did. But he didn't. He came back earlier than I expected. So with him there, man, he's blocking everything. That guy is a warrior, and they're just so tough to beat. I obviously I'm a Heat fan, as much as I hate to admit it. I mean, I don't see the Heat ever. I mean, I would be surprised if the Heat win tomorrow night because they are playing at Philadelphia. I mean, who knows? They're going to be desperate. They're going to give everything they have. But this is Philadelphia. It's going to be tough to win that game. But yeah, Philadelphia is a surprise team. I'm not saying surprise, because they're winning, what, 16, 17 years in a row before the playoffs, right? So they're already in a hot streak. So, but that thing, that's the team to beat in the East. You know, I mean, I don't think Boston, Milwaukee has a chance against them. So what about the Cavs or Toronto? You know, I mean, I feel like Sixers are the team to beat in the East.
Yeah, and the Heat has only won in Philadelphia, so maybe they could win in Philadelphia again.
Yeah, I mean, it was a must-win last game, man. I mean, I really I was really surprised that we lost. But in the end, we missed a guy like Dion Waiters, man, to make those shots. We didn't have, like, the Heat played tough, man, but it was just, we don't have that go-to score, you know, and Wade has done more than enough. You know, but I'm talking about one of our starters. They don't, you know, they don't have that. So, you know, we miss some games. I mean, I'm really disappointed in how we ended up the game that last game. I thought it was good game seven, but now I say we might be beat 4-1. I mean, the Heat do win Philadelphia. There is some hope because we'll come back game six at Miami. But I mean, Joel Embiid is playing better and better, and Simmons, man, he's a star, man. He's a future Hall of Famer. And his first year, I mean, he's a great player. I mean, things that he does so effortlessly, you know, his passing, his, you know, his defense, and the way he dunks the ball is incredible. And, you know, I think he's only going to get better. So they're the team of the future, man. I'll be surprised if LeBron joins them next year, you know, to be dominant.
Do you think we just saw Wade's last home game?
People are saying that. I don't know. I really don't know. It's 50-50, I think. Because obviously we know he still has it. You know, he still has those, you know, he could have, maybe not as consistent as he used to be, but off the bench, he could still play 20 minutes, you know, a game and still, you know, average over 10 points a game easily. So, I think it really depends. I think it depends on the off season, what happens if we get any new pieces, you know, Klay Thompson might be a free agent, or, Kyrie Leonard, you know, because the Heat really are one good player away from making deep run. They're like one guy that could get you 25 points a game, you know, that guy that the go-to guy to score. I think if we do that, then Wade might be influenced to come back. But as of right now, obviously you would think that, you know what, yeah, he's probably done. But I think if he was playing worse, you could say you don't guarantee that coming back. But he's still playing solid, man. I think he's averaging the most points per game in the series, right?
Yeah, he is.
Dragic is right there.
Which what it takes for Heat to, you know, to be Philadelphia is a vintage Wade and a half, you know. But Wade could only do so much, and the other players, you know. I mean, hey, they're learning. They're getting a taste of playoff basketball. Maybe next year they'll be better at it. But we are facing a Philadelphia team that is, in my opinion, the best in the East right now. I think the most. I was going to say surprising, but it's not surprising because they came in as a strong dominant force. But I think the Pacers are also second-best team in this playoff Eastern bracket part. But we'll see what happens. That comes to the end of our show. If you please can subscribe on YouTube, hit the subscribe button. And if you're listening to it on iTunes, hit subscribe. And if you have any questions for George, leave a comment below. Because he does not have social media yet. But, George, any final words? Anything to expect in this race to the NBA Finals?
Hey, man. 76ers are the real deal. I think they're going to – I want to say it now, which is crazy. I think they're going to go to the Finals and play either the Rockets or Warriors. And they played the Rockets early in the season, actually, and they split the series, but the Rockets barely beat them. I think they beat them by 1 point. So they match up well against the Rockets. So, man, it's going to be interesting. The Sixers are tough, man. They're a tough team. They have great shooters, play good defense. That's the team to beat, I think.
And, you know, to keep in mind, to just end this note, that, you know, the 76ers did some sacrifice. They lost on purpose these past 5 years to gain some good draft picks.
Yeah, I don't know if they lost on purpose, but they just didn't have any talent. You know, they have a lot of young guys and they didn't know what to do and injuries and stuff like that, but now they got, I mean, they really have, I mean, it's too early to tell, obviously, but Joe Embiid and Simmons, they could be two Hall of Fame players, you know, and they're prime, they're young, you build around them, they have all these veterans around that could shoot. I mean, that team is set to be basically dominant for the next 5 years minimum. So if they bring another guy in there, because they have enough room to make them better, they have enough money in the salary cap, so if they bring a guy like LeBron or something, or Klay Thompson, or Kyrie Leonard or something like that, man, it's over. I mean, the East is always weaker than the West, so they're going to be there for a long time.
We'll see how far this core goes. I'm like the Jaguars. What are the San Antonio Sixers going to do? Anyways, George,
yeah,
thanks
the coach is really good, too.
Yeah, yeah, the coach is good. Sarich, I love Sarich. He's my favorite bench player.
Yeah, he's a young guy, too. He's part of the core. Yeah, he's a young, so he'll be there for a while.
George, thanks for coming on to the Sportscast.
Thank you for having me.